Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I want to share with you five ideas to help take your Power BI reports to the next level. Just a little bit something to help your end users. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, some report ideas. We recently had our default showcase report that we use for our videos updated. Shout out to Mr. Chris Hamill, who helped us out on his free time. And these are just things that you can do in your reports to just help take it to that next level. If you're like Patrick and I, by default, when you create reports, you're just throwing visuals on the canvas and, you know, it doesn't look great, but it's passable. Maybe. And so these are things to maybe just take a little bit of extra effort to help get you to that next level. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and take a look at what these are. So you can see here, I've got a fabulous report that's got some awesome data inside of it. It looks great, right? We're done. It just looks great by default. I kid. So the first thing here, we've got the visuals on the canvas, and this is honestly typically what I see in terms of we just put some visuals on the blank canvas and didn't really do anything extra, right? We just added the fields and we were good to go. So the first thing I want to call out is custom backgrounds. These can be done to help just call out the visuals that are there, help guide the viewers from their eyes in terms of what they want to see, and just break things up a little bit. They can be very helpful. To do that, we're going to go over to this paintbrush icon. We're going to come down to page background. One thing you'll notice here, transparency is already set to 0%. I slid that down by default. That's probably going to be 100% for you. Let's go ahead and add an image. The next thing I want to do is do image fit, change it from normal to fit, and bam, look at that. Doesn't that really help? Remove it real quick so you can see the before, and then we'll add it back. Wow. And you can do this in easy ways that aren't complicated. Like, I personally use things like Adobe Photoshop, advanced design tools. Not that I'm any good at them necessarily, but you can use tools that you already have at your disposal. This background was actually created in PowerPoint. So you can create things that are simple, but definitely help to separate visuals in your report. For the second item, let's talk about themes. And you may be thinking, well, okay, everything looks okay right now, but what I'm going to do is add in a custom theme. I'm going to go up to the view icon. And then by default, right now I'm using the current theme, which is default. I'm going to hit this drop down. And there's other themes in here that you can play around with. I actually personally like the storm theme, but I've got a custom theme here. So I'm going to browse for themes. I'm going to hit my Guy in a Cube theme. You may think well, nothing really changed, but pay attention to the font sizes, the actual shape of the fonts, the actual colors, like on the lines here and the title and then the states, they went to almost a darker blue. The Guy in a Cube theme, the default color we have is a bluish color, and there is a bluish color that's very similar in the default theme. So it's not as striking from a color perspective, but the fonts you could definitely tell. And you can customize that either per visual or have an all up, hey, this is the default size and font that I want to use inside of my reports. And you can define that in the theme file. These can help illustrate your corporate brand and also the colors for your corporate brand. And when we think about colors, let's also think about accessibility, because that's very important. So make sure that you're being mindful about colors, both that they complement each other as well as are accessible for folks that may be visually impaired. And I'll have links to some of these items down in the description below for more information. So let me know what you think about that. The third idea I want to give you is taking your tooltips maybe to the next level. So you can see here, even on this line chart, I've got tooltips. These are the default tooltips that come with Power BI, and they're okay. You can actually customize some of the look and feel of these tooltips, like just the color wise. And you can also add other items in the tooltip dwell down below here. So you can add additional items. One thing I want to do though is there is a concept here called report page tooltips. I've already got one set up here. We're going to go over to the paintbrush. We're going to come down to tooltip and change this to report page. I've already got the report page set up. And so now that I'm using that report page, I can come in and bam, we've got our report page tooltip. They give us a little bit more information. Patrick's not doing too good here, but you can customize these to add information and help call out items in your report that help supplement the default visual. These can really be helpful when trying to tell that data story and just allow users to get that extra info to help them make that business decision. The other thing I want to call out in this video is these are just the ideas, right? I'm not necessarily showing you how to do these. I do have some links in the description below, as well as up above, you may have been seeing that come in, that talk more about these capabilities. So definitely check those out. Also, if there's something I showed that I don't have a link to a video, let me know in the comments below and we can look at doing a video on that. Definitely consider report page tooltips. They also help from a performance perspective as well, which is something Patrick and I really like because they defer execution of certain things, which is great. The fourth item I want to share with you is drill through, going from one item to another item. Let's take a look. Drill through can be helpful for a couple different reasons. One is that you can drill into just additional information for a specific item, or you can actually help separate from a summary level down to a detail level. So that can be very helpful, not only from just a visual storytelling perspective, but also from a performance perspective. So if you're going with larger scale of data, that is something to consider as just an option for a report flow. So let's take a look at the United States visuals. I can hover over here. We can see the great state of Texas. And if I hover over this, you'll see a little item on the tooltip that says right click to drill through. I can select this visual like normal, but if I do right click here, I can do drill through. It'll go to my state detail page, which is great. So it can have additional information. The other thing I want to call out here that you can do as well is conditional drill through. This is through the use of buttons. I'll talk about buttons here in a second. In this case, you'll see up top here, it says click a state to enable drill through. If I select that state, now what we'll see is click for state detail. So the button changed to reflect the actual selection. And then when I select that, it actually takes me to the drill through page. What? That is bananas. So these are different ways that you can use drill through to enable an experience and almost an app-like experience for your end users, which is great. The fifth idea I have for you is just that item I mentioned before, buttons combined with bookmarks, selections, things of that nature. This really helps you take your report to an app-like experience. You can control some of that navigation and other aspects of your report. So let's go back to our main page here. We've got two little icons there, which are really cool. Those icons are actually built into the background image, so they're not separate. But what we're doing is we actually have a blank button sitting on top of it that allow us to do something. So for this part, we can open a filter pane or a slicer pane, and then that will allow us to make selections accordingly. And then we can affect the visuals that are on the page. And then when we're done, we can close that out. Buttons can allow us to show things and hide things. The filter button actually displayed the slicer panel, and this X button allowed me to close the slicer panel. And that's done through bookmarks. So the bookmarks actually control what's visible and what's not. And then the buttons allow me to activate a given bookmark that is defined in the actual report. Let's look at another button here. We've got this little question mark. If I hover over this, it says open the info pane. And when I select that, it actually adds a layer in here that highlights some aspects of the report. So more context and education around how to use the actual report. And all this is doing, this is just an image overlay, and I'm just showing the image overlay. I actually have another button here that's sitting on top. I click on that, control click, because I'm in Power BI Desktop. It goes away and hides that image. Now I can just use my report like I can normally. I want to go back. Here we go. There's the info, and then I can hide it. That is cool. Specifically about that info panel, let me know in the comments if you want a video on that. Another button here that you may have noticed, we already talked about the conditional drill through button, but another button you'll see here is this decomposition. What it's going to do is actually in the current state of the report page, if I select that, it will actually change the visuals out. So it switched the visual, and then I have this return button. If I do return, it then goes back to the original display of the waterfall visual plus the table. So I can switch between a view of the data. Just a little thing to help with storytelling and to accommodate certain aspects of a given report, depending on what people want to see. So you don't have to clutter the entire report page with, you know, 100 visuals. Actually seen someone do that. You can actually do some targeted visuals for the story that you're trying to tell, and maybe provide options through buttons and bookmarks to allow people a choice of switching a given view. That's really powerful. So the buttons can be used for switching things. We can, you know, do drill through with conditional drill through. We can show and hide things. We can do all sorts of amazing things with buttons. All right, those were just a few ideas to get the blood flowing, get your idea, your brain going in terms of what you can do in your report. Let me know in the comments below what you think. If you have other ideas for report design and data storytelling, I definitely want to hear it. Let us know. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.